Sir, madam, at the outset, I would like to thank you for giving me this opportunity to participate in the discussion of the Indian Medical Council Amendment Bill 2019 on behalf of YSRCP Party. Madam, I would like to take this opportunity to express my sincere gratitude to my mentor and my beloved leader, YSRCP President and Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, and the people of my constituency and party colleagues who have helped me to come here. Speaker, sir, I also take this opportunity to congratulate all the members of this House for having got elected to the 17th Lok Sabha. Sir, our party, YSRCP, strongly feels that the Indian Medical Council Amendment Bill 2019 is a necessity and need of the hour, and hence we support the bill. However, Speaker, sir, through you, I would like to tell the Honorable Minister that, like him, I am also a medical doctor, I am a general surgeon, a urologist and andrologist. I have conducted 45,000 surgeries till now, and I come from a family of 23 doctors. With this background, I have some suggestions to improve the medical field in this India. I hope Dr. Harshavardhan ji would take note of my suggestions. I am first time MP and this is my maiden speech. I thank all of you. Now coming to the bill, Speaker, sir, there are three major valid points. The bill amends to act to reduce the time period for superposition of MCI from 3 years to 2 years. We welcome, sir. The bill amends to increase the strength of the governance from 7 to 12. We strongly support this move and we welcome it, sir. Speaker, madam, the bill also provides for the Board of Governors to be assisted. 10 lakh medical doctors, MBBS doctors, 7 lakh OIS doctors in India. There are 529 medical colleges and 71,000 MBBS seats as of now, out of which 50% of the MBBS seats are in private sector. Last year, nearly 80 colleges were denied admissions for simple reasons like lack of a conference hall, lack of one or two professors, by which we lost nearly 12,000 seats in the last academic year. So these 12,000 seats were abolished and the students were forced to go to countries like China, Russia and Philippines to study MBBS. Sir, we are stringently following the rules to recognize medical colleges of India, whereas we are not following the same rule with regards to the foreign medical institutions. We are conducting an examination of 2 hours and we are granting permission to those students who are studying in foreign medical colleges. This way we are losing nearly 400 crore rupees per year, and in order to prevent migration of students, we need to be liberal in sanctioning medical colleges in India. Secondly, sir, special incentives should be given to the colleges located in rural areas. Though we have good number of doctors in primary health care, is not as expected. This is because most of the doctors are living in urban areas. Only 23% of doctors in rural areas, they are serving 66% of the population. Rural population are forced to travel to cities and they are wasting a lot of time and money. This discrepancy can be corrected by encouraging rural medical colleges, sir. The third point, sir, I would like to make, though we are about to reach the target 1:1,000 doctors as suggested by WHO, we are way behind many countries in HAQ index ranking. HAQ is Healthcare Access and Quality Index. We stand at 145 rank. We are far behind Bangladesh and countries like Sudan. Sir, it is sad to note that we are lagging behind in BRIC countries also. Brazil, China, Russia and South Africa are also way ahead us. And there is a small consolation at the end. Of course, we are better than Pakistan and Afghanistan. The reasons for this poor HAQ ranking could be inadequate funding and inadequate paramedics. Sir, the next point is our 63-year-old curriculum needs to be changed. For the benefit of the economically weaker section's reservation, government has increased the number of seats in government medical colleges. The same provision should be given to private colleges also. This is one way to prevent migration of the students to foreign countries. Sir, last but not the least, attack and doctors need to be tackled seriously. If this is not curtailed, a day may come when parents would not allow their children to take medical profession. We have got good number of doctors, but paramedics are very less in number. We should concentrate on that aspect. Biggest fortune of any individual is health. Aragyame Mahabhagyam. So with good health comes the productivity. If our rural India is sick, productivity decreases, earning decreases, and that vicious cycle continues. Modi ji's vision of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas won't reflect on the ground. So I urge the government, through you, sir, take the appropriate measures to improve primary health care in India. Budgetary allocation should be improved. Sir, coming to the conclusion, I am a novice to the politics. I am a first timer. I follow my predecessors. I shall participate in the deliberations with Pavitra Devalayam in a meaningful way. Doctor means a teacher. I am a doctor by profession. I am a doctor of medicine. I try to be a doctor of politics also. I shall try and live up to the aspirations and expectations of our party and the people of my constituency. I represent Kurnool district, which was represented by stalwarts like Neelam Sanjeev Reddy, our ex-president, and P.V. Narasimha Rao, our ex-prime minister, sir. Sir, I would like to end my maiden speech with few words in Telugu to thank my people of Kurnool constituency. ఎంతో మంది మహాన్ భావులను ఇక్కడికి పంపించారు. నా నిజాయితీని, నా నిబద్ధతను, నా సామర్థ్యాన్ని నమ్మి నన్ను ఈ పవిత్ర దేవాలయానికి పంపిన కర్నూలు నియోజకవర్గ ప్రజలకందరికీ కూడా దాసుడనే ఉంటాను. ఆహర్నిశలు కృషి చేసి మన కర్నూలు నియోజకవర్గ సమస్యలను పరిష్కారం చేసేందుకు శాశ్వతంగా కృషి చేస్తానని మనవి చేస్తూ ఈ అవకాశం ఇచ్చిన స్పీకర్, థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ సార్.
లెట్స్ ఎంకరేజ్ హిమ్ స్పీకింగ్ ఫర్ ద ఫస్ట్ టైం.